Assalamu alaikum senior 2, I hope you all are fine. Today class we will see our second topic of final term, which is from your history portion, and the name of this topic is Decline of Mughal Empire. In today's lecture class, I will give you some information and introduction of this topic, which will help you to solve all your exercises, all your questions very easily. So listen me carefully. So class, we all know that in the previous chapters of history, we studied about the Mughal Empire. We saw that there were six Mughal kings who ruled for many years and came as the greatest power in the world. The chain of Mughal rule started from Babur, as you can see in this picture, and end with Aurangzeb, the last Mughal king. These are the six Mughal kings, the great kings of their time. Do you know, class, the Mughal Empire ruled for 2 centuries, which means 200 years. And the last king, Aurangzeb, did lots of work for Islam. You can see the Aurangzeb on the left side. He was the one who made thousands of copies of Quran and gave them as a gift to everyone. And the purpose of this activity was to spread Islam in India. But when he passed away, the empire began to slowly decline and eventually collapse. Aurangzeb had 3 surviving sons at the time of his death. And after his death, his eldest son Bahadur Shah took the throne. Although he was brave, but he was old too. You can see this in the picture on the right side. So he was unable to take care of the empire, which was a clear sign that decline of Mughals had been started. And class, because of these reasons, Marathas appeared. When they saw the Mughal empire became weaker and weaker, they were Hindus and enemies of Mughals. They lived in mountainous areas and raided frequently to capture important stuff of Mughals. And similarly, after Marathas, Nadir Shah, Persian leader, invaded Mughals in 1739 with almost 2 lakh people. He was the one who against the Mughals, so he captured Delhi and all valuable goods of Mughals. He even stole the throne of Shah Jahan, which also shows that the glory days of Mughal Empire were gone forever. Along with this class, the bad luck of Mughals were also started when the British entered in India during the time of Akbar for the purpose of trade. They established their East India Company in India, and it has greatest importance in history. Both British and their East India Company were a greatest disaster for the existence and glory of Mughal Empire, and was also the reason of decline of Mughals. So class, this was a complete topic, decline of Mughal Empire, that shows how they got weaker and weaker with the passage of time. I hope you all get it, class. Now what you need to do is to read this chapter from the book carefully for more understanding and to increase your knowledge. You can also search out more stuff about this topic. We will see our exercises in our next lecture. So class, thank you for listening to me. Allah Hafiz, take good care of yourself.